Welcome back to the Crooked Spine Show. Have you ever had problems with balance, even with falling? This workshop will give you the certain exercises and stretches to start doing to make your overall body stronger, better balanced, even able to get off the floor on your own. Today's workshop, we work with the lower body, feet, knees, and legs, with range of motion, with movement, along with standing exercise against the wall, including squats and also lunges too, with eyes open and eyes closed to help improve your overall balance. We'll also do walking exercises, walking with rolling feet, eyes open, eyes closed again for balance. We want to make sure we stress our body a little bit by closing our eyes so our body can reset itself and over time get a better balance perspective and improve that way. We end the show with also, or the workshop, even doing with getting off the floor properly, different alternatives for you too, especially if you have weaker legs or bad knees. Enjoy the workshop, my friends. Learn exercise to make your body looser, stronger, to improve your balance, improve your strength. Also avoid pain this way, and overall stay independent. All right, my friends, have a great week. We'll see you next week.
I'll send the videos, put them on YouTube, send you a link, and that we can watch again later on if you want to. It's a non-stop. So people learn sometimes certain ways, right?
I do everything on my phone.
Yes, easy. It's how people learn, the visual, auditory, or combinations of both.
The biggest thing about a phone or a computer is don't be afraid of it.
Yes. That'll shut down your brain.
Well, I think I do play games because I stimulate your brain.
It works well if you use it for the right thing. That's all it comes down to.
I listen to audiobooks at night.
Oh, gosh.
Instead of taking pills.
Yeah. I have to read books itself. I like to read books.
Yeah.
I'll get 5 pages in, also, like,
You can read, you can watch movies, you can listen to music, you can take a trip somewhere.
All right, let's get started. I got a schedule to keep. Got my phone lunch. All right, we are ready to start. Everyone in. Everyone pre-stretch after this. You saw all these exercises, right? Make sure you pre-stretch today, because it's going to be a little sore, a little tight. So, we talked about a second ago too, how do we improve our balance? Unless you have a physical injury, a permanent nerve damage, at that point, which I assume you guys walked into for the most part, some people rolled in, I get it. At that point, let's get your overall body realizing your brain controls a lot of how your balance can get better, improve. You guys up in the very front, if we can tune our brain and nerves together to cause movement, your overall body improves over time. Someone has bad posture, bad movement patterns for one too, but I want to make sure they understand you get that better with moving the right way. How does our nerves work? Where do our nerves travel in our body? Our nerves just in our brain and our head and our shoulder? Where does our nerves go through our body? Everywhere?
Yes.
Yes, right? Okay, if they're everywhere, we have to make sure everywhere is working properly, moving properly, all our joints, so nerves in our feet, we move our toes, send signals back to our brain that it's actually moving. Okay? When we stop moving, what happens is those nerves start shutting down a little bit. How do nerves work? What travels along the nerve? What travels along the nerve? What is that?
Impulses.
Excuse me?
Impulses.
Exactly. And part of it is voltage, electricity, making things want to work properly. If your voltage works properly, it takes us moving the joint, so it increases in voltage, so that point your body knows you're moving even better. If voltage increases more, then our muscles start adapting too. Our muscles start adapting because we want to make sure those muscles are working to keep our body loose and strong all the time. Why do people come to my talks? What's the number one reason, you think?
Pain.
Yeah, kind of. before pain. As a senior, what's the biggest concern as a senior?
Falling.
Losing mobility. Becoming dependent on someone to take care of me. Okay, I ask my wife to take care of me all the time. She says, no, I'm not taking care of you yet. I'm too young. But can we get things to move better so you don't have to have someone take care of you? That's the plan in life. As long as we can. Okay? So number one thing we need to talk about, when we're sitting, we're just sitting here. Just sitting here. If you need a chair, there's no need a chair. There's four chairs if you need a chair. Just sitting here. At that point, how can we start moving our body better? What's what we can do? Simple things. On here is want to roll your feet. What I mean by roll your feet is not here like this, it's more like this. Okay? We roll our feet back and forth like we're driving a type of car, I guess. I don't know. Alright? It has two pedals. But that point, by rolling your feet, what does that do to our body? You're causing a rhythm in your body for one, two, so the left and right are working together. So when I roll my feet, I'm going to do is have my, for example, my right toe on the ground, my right heel, then switch them up. My left toe, my right heel. And switch them back again to my right toe, my left heel. Going back and forth rhythmically, because over time, as we do this more and more, our brain's going, hey, what's going on now? What do most people do when they have an injury? When they walk, they start to stomp. They start walking with a stomp. They start doing this. I tell my patients, I don't want to hear your feet. Let's roll your feet naturally so your whole nerves in your foot, you have a lot of nerves out in your feet that will get them to work properly to start that process of getting your overall body to slowly get those nerves moving better. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay? This is all going to help you down the line, not only how to walk better, have better balance, but also getting up off the floor, which is my last thing, helping get off the floor properly too. The life alert button, who has the life alert button? Is that still popular? The life alert? The button that you push for someone to help you? My grandma had one. She pushed it. The problem is, no one changed the battery out for 5 years. That doesn't work. Come on, guys. So if you have the button, make sure you hit the battery maybe once a year. I don't know. My smoke detector lets me know change the battery of my smoke detectors. When does your smoke detector usually go off? When does yours go off normally?
Middle of the night.
Why is that every time? 2 in the morning. You hear like beep. Dang it, not again. Figure out which one it is, dude. So that's my side note. And it had to happen this week to me. So once we've rolled our feet enough, I tell people how they feel, how often. I go, whenever you have a chance to sit, roll your feet. Maybe a minute. And again, you're gonna have a way to figure out all these exercises for you, what you need to work on. It's just a list for me. I walked with my patient that had problems walking with balance, to someone with a cane or a walker, even in a wheelchair, I go, how do we can do things just sitting down? Number two, alter knee extension. What is knee extension? This is the extension. Here. Make sure you pay attention. It's a hard one. Boom. This is not easy for everybody. Okay? You may want to even hold on to the chair if you need to help your lower back feel more stable. Hold on to the chair and come back. Hold it up. Hold for a second and come back down. Okay? If that feels comfortable on both sides, hold it up. Back down. Then try this one. Instead of your foot being straight, now turn your foot out a little bit, then come up. See if you feel more of the inside of the knee that way. Because sometimes people, when they walk a lot, when they move a lot, outside of your leg gets real tight, inside gets weaker. The body wants to balance itself out, right? Inside weaker, outside tighter. So we're going to get that by putting your foot facing outwards. That point now, you're working the inside of your knee muscle called the VMO muscle, fast mass obliquus, blah, blah, whatever. At that point, work them individually, one side at a time. And you come up, hold that leg up for a second, and bring it back down. Contract that knee straight as much as you can to get that muscle to work. Also, point your toe at the same time to work the front muscle of your leg. How do these muscles work in your body, the front and back? Called antagonistic muscles. They have to work individually, so when I tighten up my front, I'm actually stretching the back of my calf too at the same time. If I tighten up my quad, I'm actually stretching my back hamstring at the same time. So at that point, you're working both muscles individually to allow them to relax and work together. So when we're walking, same thing, we can walk, move, get out of a chair, and not hurt ourselves. How many people think a month comes to my office, they have back pain, leg pain, hip pain, and they had no trauma, no injuries? About at least half of my patients. Because they don't work these muscles enough, because we sit so much, we want to make sure we're moving enough to get our body to actually stay strong and stay loose at the same time. Okay? So I would recommend doing this one, by the side, come up, it feels tighter in the middle, or inside of your knee, point your foot outside, one side at a time, right, for me, right first, then left second. Not to get confused, I'll say right, and then left. That wouldn't be good, confuse myself. Okay, by each side, yes ma'am.
What happens when you have pain in that quad? Why would you?
It's tight.
It's just tight?
Exactly. You're a good question. If it's tight when you pull it up and not tight when you pull it down, your quad muscle is one muscle attaches in from below your knee above through your hip. So you have to figure out where it's tight. If you feel it's tight in the middle of the muscle, what I would do is hold that muscle down and then push up. See if that feels better for now. But it's going to let you know what's tight, where is it tight, toward the knee, toward the hip. At that point, push in that area to give it a little bit of a break while you're doing that muscle get stronger. It has to work that muscle, the whole thing, from below the knee up to the calf. I have knee pain. Okay, the triceps exercise. Where does it hurt? In the muscle. Because the knee's pulling on the knee. A lot of people have knee pain to realize, first thing you should start doing is getting it stronger, not resting it, not tightening, not moving it. You want to move that knee, that ankle, that hip, that foot. Okay? Why is movement so important?
Using
it, right? If we don't use a muscle, how many people have been told, I had a patient, well, I always tell this story every year, Rachel, she came in about 5 years ago. Came in, severe back pain. Severe. I go, she had a walker, I think maybe even a cane too. Severe. I go, you're not. Took her x-rays, come to x-rays in my office, I'm a chiropractor. And x-rays were fine. I go, Rachel, what's your problem? What's going on? And she goes, well, my doctor told me 6 months ago, if it hurts, don't move. I've been watching TV for 6 months on the couch. What happened? Her muscles got shorter, tighter, weaker. Now she can barely move. I said, Rachel, you have to start moving to get your muscles stronger. You have no joint. If you have nothing that's telling you, you should be careful. At that point, she started walking around. She would say stuff in Spanish that sounded very angry to me. She's very upset because I made her move around. I don't care if you're comfortable or not, I want you better. And sometimes it's gonna be working outside your comfort level to make your body stronger when it's appropriate. We have to realize when we have an injury, what happens if we have an injury, knee injury, hip injury, back, whatever it is too, our body will naturally want to let us know, be careful. Once you get your doctor's clearance to go, hey, we're good to go, yes ma'am.
What happens when you turn over a leg and all of a sudden the muscle behind your leg will just cramp so you can't
move? The hamstring?
How does that happen?
Or the calf?
Calf.
The calf? Sometimes dehydration. Mm-hmm. When we're sleeping, how much do we move when we're sleeping? How much do we move normally?
Not a lot.
Not a lot, right? So everything's going to tighten up.
And the foot. Is the bottom of the foot the same thing?
And how does the muscle work in the foot? Your calf muscle goes from your calf muscle, goes underneath the heel of the foot, and attaches here. So realize your whole calf, thank you for that. Your whole calf muscle is part of the actual heel that becomes a tendon underneath your heel and attaches as a fascia to the front of your foot. So if this is tight here, I tell people, how's your calf feel? And vice versa. You want to make sure you stretch your calf enough before you go to bed. If not, the muscle, any muscle in your body will naturally tighten up if there's a tightness in there already. Especially after an injury or a cramp, the muscle will naturally tighten up to protect itself. So before you get out of bed, what I do, I go, first of all, take a deep breath to make sure I'm still alive. That's the first thing I do. Okay. And what I do is move my legs a little bit, see how things feel. I work out enough where I get a cramp maybe like once every couple months. I go, So you want to make sure you're moving enough, your own self-assessment, your own self-care, so your body can actually feel good getting out of bed. Most injuries occur at getting out of bed. The first half hour of your life is where I see a lot of non-traumatic injuries. Getting out of bed, brushing your teeth over a sink, a cup of coffee, that quick motion is coming out of my back. What happened? So that is when your body's going to wake up because it's too tight. So doing a stretch for your routine at all, whatever it is, You can stretch at least once a day, if not twice. I like stretching in the morning. That's my routine. Can you figure out a routine for you to stretch every day? Tell my younger patients stretching days to end with Y, because that's every day. Okay, that one allows your body to feel that consistency, that routine, part of your daily life. That point, the cramping might still occur, but less frequently. That's your question? It's all comes down. And hydration too. What happens if we're getting this April 9, April 2023, getting into March, getting into May and June, it gets warmer. People don't realize we've got to start drinking more water. We have to hydrate more for one too. That's part of our change in environment. So, all right? Good? Yes, ma'am.
I walked into the apartment.
Yeah.
I had my vacuum cleaner standing up because I was going to clean the floors. Mm-hmm. And instead, I walked right into it. And I hurt my small toe.
Yeah.
It got swollen, but I got it's all. You can see it from here.
Yeah. Confirm, sir. Confirm. Thank you.
So what I do is just walk. Turn it around like you said we should, and it's getting better, but it takes longer because we're older.
No, I don't like the age thing. I don't use the age thing with patients.
Okay.
OLD does not exist in my terminology.
Okay.
I still have a Webster dictionary hanging somewhere in my closet or my bookshelf. It takes time, yes, but doing the right things for the body to heal. The physiology is still there, it takes more time for the blood flow to get there.
Yeah,
it takes more work. Yeah. It's more consistency of the stretching. Icing or heating if need be, every day.
Yeah.
So you're, yeah.
I do what you said we should do. That's what I do.
Move that foot around.
I turn it around and it's getting bad. I have no pain.
It takes time.
But it takes time and I walk. Mm-hmm. And make sure I got my feet correct and not go this way or that way.
That we talked about before too, making our feet are stable. We'll talk about at the end too, how we're going to walk, how we're going to move things around. But we want to make sure if we're all going to have injuries. That's life. If you live long enough, it's going to happen. How do we recover? How do we know it's safe to start doing physical therapy, safe to start moving? That point, we have to move right away. If someone has knee surgery now, what do they do now for knee surgery? They want them walking the same day, moving the same day. Why is that? We want to prevent scar tissue. We want to cause things to move. That point, they will be tight, will be sore. We got to move as much as fast as we can. All right? Next one here, too, we have a list here. We've done the feet rolling. We've done knee extensions for 1-2. Also, leg lifts. Very similar. I have people sit in front of the chair if that's possible. At that point, just lift your leg as much as you can. Feel that hip really contracting your hips. Coming up, hold for a second, then come back down. Try to keep your back straight the whole time as much as you can. Come up, hold, come back down. Let's get all these muscles in your hips stronger also. Here, hold, come back down. Where can it cause pain? Hips and lower back.
Yeah.
So you want to make sure we're moving stuff enough. Up, hold, come back down. And just for a second, I just want you to start doing this. It'll start stomping. It'll look weird. All right, don't do that. Come up, hold, and then come back. Okay, try to keep your body still. The goal is just to move these muscles in the hip, not this. No, that'd be bad. I'd give you a thumbs down on that one. All right? Body up, hold. Come back now. We want to work individual muscles, not whole body yet. So again, I recommend 5 on each side. I do a 5 rule for everything. If I hold for 5 seconds, on some exercise, this one just a second. At that point, 5 on each side. Keep your body still the whole time. Now we're going to stand. This is going to be exciting now. Start doing now. Here. I want to check your posture first. Okay, so who wants to be my man in white today? Or Mr. Man or White? Anybody? Come on over, man. My normal volunteers, step it up.
Is camera bothering you, sir? Is that okay?
No, that's fine. It's okay. Good.
Just want to make sure.
You're good.
So right here, ma'am. As you've done before, watch out for nails in the wall. Up against the wall for me. Heels, hips, shoulder, and head. This is how I check my patient's posture. Does that feel comfortable, ma'am?
Yes.
Fantastic. She said yes. She's been in my class before. Here, standing here, we want our heel against the wall, hips, shoulder, and head. At that point, our body is going to be stationary. People will sometimes say, it feels uncomfortable. Where? My lower back, my hips, because they're used to this. Okay, I want you to focus on what is ideal normal, how do we get there, so get our body in better position first. If I have someone work out and do stretches and exercises here, it's going to do what? It's going to reinforce this posture, not this posture back here. We practice beforehand. Okay, take a step forward from him. Is it Gwen?
Gwen.
Gwen, and then Gwen here. Weight on your heels, Gwen. Weight on your heels and lean back a little bit on your upper body.
I'll probably tip over.
That's okay, you won't tip over, your butt will kick in. You won't tip over. Never mind. My standard didn't work today. So lean back on your heels a little bit so we can track the muscles back here. Good. How does that feel?
That's okay.
I know you have some other issues going on too, but that's ideal. Wherever you're comfortable in your body, wherever you're comfortable, go back in the heels a little bit. At that point, if weight's on our heels, our body stays on the wall posture. That's the plan. All right? Thank you, Ms. Glenn. Appreciate it. Good job. Okay. So once you checked our posture, now we get stronger here instead of being stronger here. That's the plan. If we're stronger here, what happens is, you know, we have tighter hips again. We have a problem with lower back. So focus on posture first. Also strengthen the quads now too. So your quad strength, how do we strengthen the quads? What are your quads? Right here. Here and here and here. They help you walk, stand, get off the floor, get out of bed. If they're stronger, I want to build strength, I want you against the wall, heels up, maybe a foot away from the wall. And now, bring one leg up at a time, pull them off if you need to, come up, hold, and come back. You can just see it too if you want, just like the leg lift before too. Come up, hold, and then relax. Versus the seated, now you have to use your other muscle like you do with walking to make that right leg come up. The left muscle of your glute has to contract so you don't shift to one side. That makes sense? When I walk, I'm taking a step, correct? That step makes the other muscle work so your body stays the center line, doesn't shift over the whole time. Any questions about that? So leg lifts off the wall for a quad strength exercise. Recommend 5 on each side. Come up, hold for 1 second, then come back down. If you can go waist high, cool. If not, go as far as you're comfortable. And make sure that hip's stable. You use the wall you can if you need to, and switch sides if you need to. Any questions about that one? Simple, easy, right? So far, okay. This is a fun one. So now, assisted lunge. Okay, so what I want to do for this one is here, using a chair for balance. He's a gentleman. And you're a gentleman too at the same time. There's no chair there if you want to.
I'm
there. There's a folding chair there.
Oh, that was his chair.
I know, and I have to stand the whole time, but you feel bad.
She's working.
Okay, good. Wow. All right. So here, we do now, it's a little bit lower camera. I want to use the floor a little bit, and it's a little tough for some people. Here, it's going down to one knee. Who likes to do this? Nobody does. So here, I want to use a chair. I want to come down to one knee and just hold that position. Okay? I want to understand for you what feels uncomfortable. Because this side felt comfortable, this side would feel comfortable too. When you come up, I want you to use that chair and your hand here. So in this, if you're watching the video, my right hand is on the chair, my left hand is on my left thigh, right above my knee, and pushing up my left hand, my right hand also, and coming up this way. That seem easy? Fantastic. Come on over, Miss Easy. Yes, I always beat people in to help. Bait them in, that's what my goal is in life. Alright, so again, just to see, I'm going to come down on my right knee, using chair for balance. When I come up, I want to put weight on my left hand, up right above my left knee. My weight on my right knee, this might be easier too. More on the seat of the chair versus the back of the chair here, and push up with my right hand, left hand simultaneously, to come up and come straight up, bring my right foot next to my left foot. Boom. I think it's one of them. Okay? Let's see. Come on over, ma'am. You want the back or the, what feels comfortable for you? On the top or the bottom? Yeah. Here we go. Let's see. Step one complete. Boom, she made it to the floor. Good work. You can now skip forward more. I'm going to bring this actually back a little bit. That's okay. Now, he's out there. You go. Oh, yes.
Well, that looked easy, but it's not
whoa.
That easy.
What do you feel? Where do you feel muscle tightness? Perfect. Good. Because when you're coming up off the floor, that lower leg is almost having to work a little bit, contracting that thigh to come up. So for you, it's working on the leg, standing leg lifts, or the seated leg lifts too, would help get that hip stronger. And then switch sides for me too. I'll bring this chair over here for you. This side. Let's try this side now. Good. There we go. Left leg back, front leg forward. On the floor. Good. Made it. All right. Make sure that we'll put more weight on that side here. And then come up. There we go. Boom. Makes it look easy. All right. That's okay. Where do you feel that one? On that left side?
Yeah.
So working on, for you, working on those leg lifts would get that hip stronger.
Okay.
Good
on
work.
A chair or on the back.
Good work. I love all the participation today. Okay. So we've done that one for one, two. Also, Okay. So we'll do this one. Front, back, whatever. Doesn't matter to me. So, and again, you can do this one also here, where if you want to try it, close your eyes at the same time. So coming down, one leg back, close your eyes. That point, I'm going to actually switch my legs. Here. That one with your eyes closed now, hand, right hand on your right quad, right above your knee, left foot back, push up. So you're going to feel where your body weight is. I want my body weight more on my right leg, push up with that one to come straight up this way. Is eyes closed harder or easier, you think?
Harder.
Because using your body to sense where things should be versus your vision to really focus on something that's not moving properly. Not moving, just in general. Alright? Another one here too. Put it all together now. Walking. Okay. When I walk, how should I walk? The way I normally walk. But again, we talked about earlier when you're sitting down, I don't like for people to stomp. When they stomp, that's going to cause a knee problem, foot problem. It also comes usually from an injury they had before. So my thing is, I want someone to have hand on the wall. I want to do is put my left foot forward to start, just my own preference. And I want to be on my left toe, my left heel, sorry, my right toe a little bit, and just roll forward. Okay? Without moving my feet, just roll your feet back and forth to get that feel of where your body is. Some people will roll and they'll come out a little bit. They'll roll and want to lean back to the right. So you're going to have a preference with your stronger leg. I want you to focus on, with my eyes open, my head straight going forward, can I roll forward and keep my head up the whole time to build confidence that my body is going to do the right thing? It takes time, movement, it takes practice. People come to my office in a lot of pain sometimes. When they get out of pain, they still feel comfortable of moving properly. Because they still have that fear, that I'll call PTSD, that injury's still there. They have to get them to understand, by moving slowly, they can get that PTSD, that mental block, to build that confidence that their body is healed by moving better. Any questions about this? I'd recommend 5 times on one side, going back and forth, and switch sides so you get more comfortable on the right side too, back and forth this way, up on your heel, just roll your feet back and forth. Your own little personal rocking chair. All right? Questions? Yeah. And again, yes, ma'am.
Do we all have the stronger side?
Yes. We all have a dominant side, like a right-handed, left-handed. We've all learned to favor one side when we get out of the chair, when we get out of a car, get out of bed. Who has a favorite side, the side of the bed? I do.
No, right?
I'm married, so I get whatever side my wife doesn't want. That's my favorite side. That's what I do. All right. So that point, having that favorite side allows, okay, I have to get away from that to make sure my body, if I fall left, if I fall right, I make sure my body can both ways, reflex-wise, get myself from falling completely or getting up from that side too. So if I had now tried with your eyes closed, that point both sides, it may feel a little comfortable, but having your hand on the wall allows you now to regain your balance if you feel left and right. So this wall is going to help protect you and wanting to overcompensate and fall down and try to sue me or something. Oh, sue me. I don't have any money. Broke. Getting married. Alright? So now from here, eyes open, eyes closed for one, two. Bone your feet. Front and back for one. And I want you to do this practice now here because I'm eyes open, eyes closed. Is how do you now walk this way? Crazy, right? Can I walk taking steps instead of just staying in one spot here? Now walk this way with my head up the whole time. I'm going to bring my left foot so you can see on the video too. Left foot coming forward. Hold for a second. Right foot coming forward. Roll my right foot so my left foot heel comes up. Keep going about three or four steps. At that point, pause every time. When you pause or slow down, you're walking. Is it more uncomfortable? More unbalanced? Yes. I want you to feel unbalanced with this exercise so you get your balance to retrain itself. Get more comfortable over time. Okay, if we're comfortable all the time, our body will not change. Our body needs to feel some type of stress, a little bit of stress, because it goes, hey, what's going on? How do I change? What do I have to adapt? What's going on? So do the same thing backwards too. Here, left hand on the wall, right foot forward first, right heel, let that heel drop, left foot come up, pause for a second, let the left foot come forward on that heel, let the left foot go forward, pause for a second, head up the whole time. When you're comfortable this way, then turn around, now close your eyes. Okay, again, we come here, close my eyes, left foot forward on my left heel, come forward real slow, hold it for a second, right foot comes forward, hold that foot real slow, come back forward, you do about three or four spaces. Okay, give yourself time to realize, I may feel good this way, going on my left foot forward, my right hand on the wall, but I turn over, my other side, my left hand against the wall, my right foot coming forward first, I'm going to feel like I'm going to one side. So by doing that, then you know what your problem might be when your eyes are closed. That point, you're using your body weight, your body's normal balance. Then we know how to retrain it. My feet are uneven. My knees are uneven. My body has to learn how to balance that. We have the same thing too. If I go here, same thing. Come here, may feel off balance one way or another. So your dominant side doesn't take over both sides. When you're going forward, that weight's on your left leg with your left leg going forward. Your back leg is working as much. If that's not your dominant side, realize it may feel a little bit off. Okay? So, again, second part of your walking exercise will be going from step one, rolling your feet, eyes open. Then from there, step two, rolling your feet with your eyes closed. Okay? Once you've done it forward three or four times to feel comfortable, you have good health insurance, right? Everybody has good health insurance? For the most part? Good enough? Okay, now what we're going to do, with your eyes open, we're going to take a step back with your right foot on your right toe, and then roll that right foot back so your left foot comes up. The whole time, pause for a second, bring that left toe up on your left toe, let that left foot roll backwards, and slowly come backwards about three or four paces. All right, feel good? You're like, oh, that's not going to happen ever. No, it's going to take time to build up that confidence you can do it on your own. And hand on your wall allows you to stay that balance. Get him to do the same thing this way. I'm gonna be my left foot first, going backwards, my left foot on the wall, coming back, head up, right foot on my right toe, coming back, head up the whole time. Okay? A couple more paces here. Now what's the last thing I'm gonna do, you think? The last thing I'm gonna do, you think? What's the last one? Eyes are open, so now I'm gonna do is eyes closed, yes. Someone's awake in the room. Someone's awake. Someone's asleep in the back, but someone's awake. Okay. Now I'm going to do now is my head's up to me the whole time. I'm going to roll my feet with my eyes closed. Okay? Crazy, right? Right foot come back. Eyes closed, hand on the wall. Come back, take a step. Feels a little off balance. Not as easy. By doing this, now you're training your brain. If you're walking backwards, anyone have eyes in the back of their head besides my mom? No one does for the most part. If you can't, you're not going to know what's behind you. So by doing this exercise, you can catch yourself, oh, I caught myself. At that point, instead of falling back, returning yourself, have to push your life alert button. All right, any questions then? Who wants to try this? Anybody? Any takers today? Anybody? Want to try this? We'll find out when you get up here. Let's see. What I'm going to do is have you go here against the wall. I'll show you first. I'm going to have you do from that position is put your right foot forward, and roll your foot out. Left foot forward, roll your foot out. Head up here. Good. And then head against the wall too. Let's turn around that way, same thing. Head up the whole time, look up here. Exactly, focus something way out there. Don't look down. Because right now you're in a safe spot because your neck against the wall. And make sure this is going, nothing's on the floor. Come on, just want to make sure. Okay, don't hurt yourself. Does that feel okay?
Yeah.
Good. Turn around this way. Same thing, now close your eyes.
Okay.
And bring your right foot up. Roll your right foot. Close your eyes. No cheating. Other side. How's that feel?
Good.
Yeah! This is scaring me a little bit. Sorry about that. All right, and turn around too. Turn around. Eyes closed again. Eyes closed. Use the wall for balance. Nice and slow. Eyes closed. No cheating. Good. How does that feel? That's okay. We have to be unstable to get stable.
Yeah.
We have to practice.
I'm there.
We're unstable already. Got it.
Yeah, that's why I'm here.
Turn around. Last we're going to do now is we're going to actually scoot forward. Here. And I'm going to have you do is now come back with your eyes open, heads up, head up, and roll your right foot back. So come back, there we go, left foot back. There we go. Like we're forward, just the opposite direction. Good, so bring your toe here. We're going to go here, right foot, and roll that foot back. We're going to switch sides, left foot, roll that back. How's that feel?
I'm more stable this way.
A little bit, yeah. You're actually doing okay that way. Now turn around this way, same thing. And which side, when you do this, does this side feel easier or the right side? Let's try that and see. Head up the whole time. Right foot on your toe. Let that right foot roll backwards. Now left foot on your toe. Let the left foot roll backwards. Good. Head up the whole time. Good. Good.
His knee is going
back. That's something you got to watch for and see. That's the thing. You're gonna know what your weakness is when you do this exercise.
I do know. That's why I'm
here. Perfect. Good. Face that way. Now. Face that way. You do now. We're gonna close our eyes. We're gonna take a step back in your right foot. Come back that way. Close your eyes though. Use the wall for balance. I'm gonna put my hand right in your shoulder here so keep you balanced. Good. Get that right foot back. Good. Good. Like it. Close your eyes. No cheating. Now turn around that way. Let's go this way. Good. Give your hand your shoulder so you don't fall. And close your eyes. No cheating. Right foot back first. Other right foot back. Good. Other foot too. Good. Eyes closed. No cheating. Good. One more time. Perfect. What's your name?
Betty.
Betty, thank you for your help, Betty.
Well,
grab
you.
A seat. Woo! Good workout today. And then last one for the finale. Okay. How do we get up off the floor? Painful. Yes, so I'm going to show you my technique I use for my patients. Okay. So you may want to use, may not, it's up to you. It's free country, whatever. Okay. So here, what I'm going to do, if I'm on the floor, okay, let's say I'm on my back. Okay. If I'm on my back, I'm like, first of all, I'm going to go, how did I get here? What happened? Okay. So I want to make sure everything we said earlier too. Does everything feel good? If I move my ankles, move my hands, move my arms, move my hips, does everything feel good when I'm on the floor? If it does, I'm gonna go here on my stomach a little bit. Actually, let's do this on your side. This way. Here, I'm gonna come here. I'm gonna make sure everything moves properly. Okay? Before I do anything. Okay? But then I'm gonna come on my back a little bit. I'm gonna come here. I'm gonna put one foot forward. I'm gonna use the chair if I can. Here, and like I did earlier too. I'm gonna push myself up a little bit. On my hand on my left knee, my left foot's forward. Push up with my just this way, so you can see it easier. I'm gonna push up here and I'm trying to get my right knee behind me. So I'm gonna push with my left hand on my left knee. My right hip, I'm gonna use my hand to try to get my knee behind me this way and come back, get back in that lunge position. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. So, yes, ma'am.
If you have knee replacements.
Don't do this. Push your lifeblood button, call for help. But you can't, but if you need to, this is a good way to even start. If your bad knee is your right knee, I would almost put your left knee back.
If you have both. I have both.
Yeah. Pick your poison if you have both knee replacements. Is it better to be on the floor at this point or better to get up? That's your decision, not mine. But if you feel you have to get up off the floor, because there's a fire or something, I don't know. The gas leak from the house. Okay. Made up stories now. If I'm here, I want my left, for me, I want my left foot forward. I want to bring that my right knee behind me. I let my right arm push me up a little bit to slide my right knee behind me. From here, as you saw before, so I'm going to come up here, put my hand on my knee, but I have something to hold on to. I can here and push myself up again, like we did earlier, correct? Okay, if that's possible. Okay, if you can do it without the chair, you can practice what you practice without the chair and come up by putting your both hands on your one knee and then putting all the weight on that left knee, my left knee being forward, then get up that way, that's the best way to practice. Because you may not have a chair next to you, or a table, or a bed. Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am.
So in her case, can she just crawl?
Of course.
And push up with...
If she can do that, that's easier for you too. If I'm here, and I'm stuck here, okay, you may need to even come down to a chair, use your hands, get on knees temporarily, then get up this way.
Okay.
If need be. That's easier for you.
I had to do that.
Yeah.
It really hurts.
It doesn't feel good, but you're up on, though. No longer lying down at the ceiling. It's a good thing. But wherever it's comfortable for you, that would get alternatives, it could be your thing. I can do this here the best way. Here, under my right leg now. Here, bend my right leg. At that point, use my right hand on my right knee, push my knee through, and get up on that one knee, if possible, or use a chair, and push up your body this way. You can practice this. At that point, if you don't have something next to you, then you can get up without that, feel confident, you can get up on your own. Questions about that? Need a water break. It's hot.
Isn't a lot about training your brain to do it, your body to do it, your brain?
Yes. We do the exercise so when we have to do it, we can do it without thinking. We know the muscles work. We're not going to hurt myself more. I'll try to avoid injury by training the muscles and the joints to work in balance. So if you have, time comes, you can do it without causing more injury. Why do people fall? They don't practice how to get up. They don't practice their balance all the time. We have to make sure our body can handle that if you want to call it that situation if need be. Now we walk, all of us walk, but do we walk consciously how our body positions? What muscle takes to get there? If I had to switch one side to left, or if I step on something, can I get my balance back? All the tips I gave you like maybe I think 1,000 exercises or something, I'm not sure. At that point, these exercises will help you get your body strong enough, balanced enough, get your body off the floor if need be. Also using alternatives if you need to too. If you walk backwards and may fall, that's when you're able to catch yourself also. It just takes the time, effort, and work doing this even once a week to get your brain to reset everything over time. Yes, ma'am.
What am I missing is fear?
Mm-hmm. Yep, exactly. Fear happens because sometimes we don't know what we can do.
First,
we're focused on what we can't do. These exercises will help you overall get your body so you can do, get over the fear that you can't do it. By doing something allows you to get the confidence that I am strong, I have good balance. It takes training and someone to let you know that you can do it. They may not all feel good to you, all these exercises, but it will help you over time feel like what you need to work on yourself if something doesn't feel good. You have to have a self-assessment every day almost of what feels good, what doesn't feel good, what do you have to work on today. I go to bed and go, man, my back's a little sore. You go stretch out before I go to bed. But tomorrow's good. I want to make sure tomorrow's good by doing stuff today. At that point, things can feel better the rest of my life as much as possible. 5 years, something like 5 years. See me?
Every morning he stretches before he goes
to church. And that's my reason. I stretch every morning. I stretch 15 minutes before I do anything, cup of coffee.
At
that point, it's done. It's done. When you have a routine and you have a routine, your brain knows, I get up, I stretch. I get up. I don't get up and go, maybe I'll stretch today. No, it's my routine. I stretch every day. When you have that routine, your body's used to it. It wants to do that every day. When you get, sometimes you won't be able to get your stretches, and you're like, I missed something. Ugh. You feel like that's a good feeling, because it's your routine. You feel out of routine. Any questions at all? Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
I had a knee issue recently.
Yes.
Which, you know, comes and goes. But I was given a little four-wheel thing to sit on.
Yeah.
I got better by the time I really needed to use it. And then I was given one of these walkers.
Yep, the stand-up walkers.
And is there a certain way to figure out if it's the right height?
Good. Huh. Perfect.
We talked about this actually a couple of months ago, too. So,
height, can everyone?
Oh, help yourself.
Thank you very much. I won't take it with me. I'll borrow for a second. What I want to do was when we talk about height, we talked about earlier the wall posture, correct? We want to be back here. Same thing with this. I want your body back here as much as possible, on your heels, walking here, not using the walker to hold your body weight. This will train your body to do what? Stay here. Ugh. I see it because I'm with the posture. That's me. Okay? I want to make sure you're back here. Even if you can, if it feels comfortable for you, get your body to lean back even further. Extend your elbows out so I'm here. Stand up for me. I'm going to check your alignment on this thing. Here you go. You got it.
I just feel so
good. Hold my hands when you need to, okay? Go over here. So here, stand up with your hand here.
Am I too low?
Let's see. Stand up straight for me.
Okay.
Lean back a little bit for me.
This?
Right there.
This seems low.
Good. So elbow straight. Elbow straight. How does that feel?
Good.
Because I have to. Now take a couple steps forward. Good. And feel like your shoulders relaxed. Your shoulders relaxed. There we go. There we go. Boom. Perfect posture. It's a model for this thing. The model for the equipment. Turn around for me. Let your shoulders relax. Relax your shoulders. You're still guarded from the fall, probably. Your shoulders relax a little bit. How's that feel?
It feels good, but when I fell, I got up like you did. I put the leg in there. I held onto the car. The car got nailed.
Perfect.
Twice I hit the car.
Perfect. Don't hit the car again.
I won't.
How's that feel?
It feels good.
And make sure, if anything, our head, if possible, is here. Our head's here. We're looking down over our nose. I'm looking down, but my head's here, so I'm not trying to get my body to do this.
Okay.
Once you drop your chin a little bit, your whole body will naturally hunch forward. Chin up, looking down over your nose as much as you can. So your body stays back on your heels. We want to move forward.
So you walk that way all the time?
All the time.
Okay.
All the time. It's practice, it's practice.
Okay.
Practice.
Yeah.
Try with the eyes closed, but don't try your eyes closed yet.
Okay.
All right.
Are there a certain number of feet to try to look out ahead of you?
Maybe 5 feet. Wherever your vision is, wherever it is for you, for 1, 2, wherever you're comfortable.
Now what about a cane? I see people with canes leading way.
Up front.
Is there a certain height it's supposed to be?
I like waist height for everybody. Waist height for 1, 2.
Over
here. Yeah. That point, if I'm having to lean forward over the cane, which most people do, too much pressure, and that cane further up. That point, I want to make sure when I stand against the wall, my body feels the cane's here. When I have to lean over to actually pull the cane. And if I have to carry your cane, then throw the cane away. Your feet are fine. Legs are fine. All right, any other questions? You guys good to go? At the bottom of my sheet has my YouTube channel. I'm going to load that probably by this afternoon on my YouTube channel. So if you want to watch again, you can, for all the comedy. Okay? Anything else? You guys good? Get the heck out of here and grab some food and go to lunch.